So, good afternoon. Welcome to this live session. Good afternoon. Good afternoon. Hello. So we'll start with the today's session. Okay, so meanwhile people will be joining. So myself, MD Rizwan, those who are new for this class, just a brief introduction of myself. And good afternoon. So in this month, as you are keeping a track of all these sessions what we are discussing, so related to geography and ecology and environment, that is our primary focus is on the prelims exam. Okay, so till now in this month we have done the topics of we have covered UNFCCC, Sustainable Development and Sustainable Development Goals, then Protected Area Network and Plate Tectonic Theory. These topics we have done in last week. And today's topic is the coral reef. Okay, that is today's 23rd. Tomorrow we will be discussing volcanism and landforms associated with volcanism. And the last topic in this month, in next week, is tropical cyclone. So again, we will be coming up with seven important topics in the month of April, and again seven important topics in the month of May, like that. So total it will be around 28 to 30 topics, important topic we will be covering by the date of your prelims exam, that is 2nd of June 2019. So our idea here of all these live sessions is to see that you are getting some support system here, support for your preparation, particularly those who are attempting or going to attempt prelims 2019. Okay, so myself, Hemdeer Rizwan, I am teaching now live at Unacademy Plus. These are all structured courses for the prelims as well as mains exam. And as far as my experience goes in teaching for the civil services, last 14 years I have been teaching, that is for the civil services exclusively. But it was like more the offline teaching. Now this is the first platform where I'm teaching online, so you can go for the subscription here. The referral code will be rizwan.md, and from 6th of April 2019 I'm starting a course on ecology and environment on the Plus platform. Okay, ecology and environment, this is covering all the topics that are related to both your prelims as well as mains. As you know that ecology in mains is in general studies paper 3. Okay, paper 3. And in case of prelims also, ecology will be an important area for you, because you have around 10 to 15 questions from ecology and environment in this segment in your prelims exam out of 100. So this course can be useful for those students who are going to attempt prelims as well as aspiring to attempt mains this year in 2019. So 6th of April, you can just mark this as an important date for those who are subscribing for the Plus courses. You can go through the entire schedule of the course also. You'll get an idea what are the topics which will be covered there. Right. So let us begin with the today's session. So very, very important topic for prelims, mains, current affairs, interview, okay, etc. You'll find that almost in every stage of your preparation, you will be finding the coral reefs and topic related to coral is going to be very, very important. right? So here we will, in today's session, we will try to understand what are corals and what are the physiology of the coral reefs. What is the significance of corals? What are their types? What are the distribution of corals? And what is the condition for formation of the corals? And we will also study what is a meaning of coral bleaching, right? And all these topics what I am covering today, as far as conceptual understanding goes, can be a part of objective or the prelims questions also. Okay, so be careful in this topic, right? And try to have more holistic and multi-dimensional approach for understanding this topic, right? Now, I hope that audio is clear, you are not getting any disturbance before. Yeah, please let me know. Yes, you have clarity of audio. Right. So, let us move. See, this is a picture of a coral island, okay, coral island, and where there are landmass here somewhere, okay. So, and adjoining landmass, see, this is the area where there is a formation of the corals, okay. So, this is the coral formation, right. So, it appears like this. This is like in case of India, you can have in areas of Lakshadweep or Andaman and Nicobar. So there are many islands, Lakshadweep particularly, most of the islands in Lakshadweep are coral, and some of the islands in Andaman and Nicobar islands are also coral islands. Okay. Now, just to have an idea, I have just put a picture here. Now, let us understand what do you mean by the coral reef. Ab dekhiye isme, you have these two words actually, the coral and a reef. Okay, so I can divide this and reef as one separate thing and a coral as another. So what is coral? Coral are the marine organisms. Okay, marine organisms, and reef is a structure. Okay, reef is a structure created by the life cycle of the corals. Reef is a structure created by the life cycle of the corals. So marine living organisms and reef is a structure. So coral belongs to what? Biotic, is a biotic component, or reef is the non-living, or you say abiotic structure that is created out of corals. So if you want an analogy here, you can relate it with this honey bee hive. Now honey bee is an organism, and what is hive? Hive, suppose this is a hive like this. This is attached in this way, so this will be hive here. So this hive is a structure, is a structure which is created out of the life cycle of the honeybee. Same thing. So honeybee here is a biotic and a hive is abiotic. So isi tarah se, coral is a biotic component. It is an organism. It is a marine organism. And reef is a structure that comes as a result, as an outcome of this marine organism. So these organisms are along with their, so they have some skeletal cover, and along with their skeletal covers, they are known as the hard covers. They are known as what? Polyps. So coral, when you say only coral, so this will be a living organism, okay, living organism. And reef will be, reef is non-living structure, okay, non-living structure. So how is reef formed? Reef is formed by accumulation of the skeletal remains of the corals. Reef is formed due to accumulation of the skeletal remains of the corals. Now let us understand in this way that see, these organisms, suppose this is a coral, so they may be in different shapes like this, right? So now this is a coral, and what this, as it is an organism, and you should understand that they are living in colonies. They will colonize. Colonize matlab they are living in huge number together. They are not going to live in an isolated manner. Okay. So they are not living in an isolated manner. So they are going to colonize. Okay. Colonize. So these corals, they will be having on their body, they will have algae. There is an algae attached to the coral. Okay. Algae attached to the coral. Now coral is an organism, means what? It is a heterotroph. Coral is a heterotroph, and it cannot prepare its own food, right? So it is depending on this algae for the food. So we say that there is a symbiotic relationship between coral and algae. Okay, what is symbiosis? When the two species are mutually benefited from one another, this will be known as a symbiotic relationship, right? So here also corals have a symbiotic relationship with the algae, right? So this coral, now what algae will do? Algae is going to produce food. That is, algae is taking sunlight. So sunlight taken by the algae, this is algae, and this algae is going to have photosynthesis and produce the food or nutrient, and this food is given to, this is given to corals. So corals get the food from the algae, and algae is going to get the substratum, okay, substratum, or you say place of residence. In that way, both the species are benefited from each other. Both the species are benefited from each other. Therefore, it is an example of symbiotic relationship, or you can say it is a mutualism also. Okay. But mutualism has a different perspective or different dimension. So it is much more stronger than mutualism. Okay. A strong relationship, a strong attachment between the two algae, that will be referred as symbiotic. Okay. Mutualism mein kya hoga? Both are benefited in mutualism, but separation is possible. Yes, are you following these things? So here we are saying that the corals and algae, they are interrelated with each other, and the survival of the coral depends on algae, right? So now second important thing is the corals do not have their own colors, or there is no much coloration originally or naturally existing on the corals. So whatever, suppose this is a coral like this, it appears to be a plant like structure, but it is an animal. So this coral is going to have the color because of what? Algae. So algae is providing the coloration to the corals, remember. So So you might have seen in this National Geographic Discovery and all, when they show the life underwater, they show generally this coral. They create a beautiful structure, colorful structures, and they may appear like different plants, different organism altogether, but they are nothing but the colony of a coral. So these corals, they are getting the color because of algae. Different pigmentation of the algae, maybe different species of algae that is attached to the coral, is going to provide different colors. Lekin, if this symbiotic relationship between the coral and algae is breaking, means algae is leaving the coral for any reason, what will happen? The corals are going to appear like dull in color, means they will be experiencing reduction in color, or you say it is decoloration of the corals. So ye jab decoloration hoga, slowly as the complete this algae is disassociated, you will find that the coral, they turn into colorless bodies. This process of decoloration is known as the process of bleaching, तो समझ में आ रहा है. सो व्हाट इज ब्लीचिंग? ब्लीचिंग इज नथिंग बट ब्रेकडाउन ऑफ सिंबायोटिक रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द कोरल एंड अल्गी, राइट? सो जब कोरल इज गोइंग टू मूव अवे, सॉरी अल्गी इज गोइंग टू मूव अवे, ऑटोमेटिकली द कोरल्स विल डाई, राइट? बिकॉज दे आर नॉट गोइंग टू गेट फूड. ओके, दे आर नॉट गोइंग टू गेट द फूड, एंड बिकॉज ऑफ विच they appear white or colorless bodies. Okay, colorless bodies. And this whitening or decoloration of the coral because of breakdown of symbiotic relationship between the coral and algae is known as a coral bleaching. Now, in this slide, I hope that you are getting what is meaning of the coral, what is reef, and what is a coral bleaching, and what is the mechanism here. Yes. Now, what is the significance of these corals and a coral reef? Yeah, zooxanthellae, what you people are mentioning here, is one of the common form of algae, most common species or type of algae that is found attached with the coral. Okay, that is correct. But you can understand zooxanthellae is not the only type of algae, it is most common, right? So let us understand what are the significances of the coral reefs. So first is, they hold the highest biodiversity, right? So therefore they are known as rainforest of ocean. Okay, the concentration of biodiversity, if you see in the water, is highest in the coral reefs, in the region of coral reef. Therefore they are considered as the rainforest of the ocean. They say on the land highest biodiversity is found where? It is found in the equatorial forest, or equatorial forest means that is lying between 10 degrees to 10 degrees north and south. Similarly, the highest biodiversity in water is found in the coral reefs. Therefore they are referred as rainforest. Then they help in coastal stabilization. Coastal stabilization means particularly filtering of water and protecting the water from the excessive sedimentation, etc. So they have multiple functions at the coast, right? Then they are the sources of new medicine. Now here we can understand that the new pharma research have indicated that the bodies of the corals, they secrete lot of chemicals that are useful for as a raw material, you can say, or they are useful for the formulations of the medicines related to chemotherapy or cancer, arthritis, and so and so. So critical diseases. So the new pharma research have indicated the importance of the corals in medicine. They are important for the nutrient cycling. Nutrient cycling, this may be the cycling of the gases as well as matter that is happening in the oceans near such regions. Then they also hold the endemic species. Endemic species means there are many species which are adapted, okay, which are adapted to the corals. Means they are so adapted that they have been named after the coral itself, like you have coral fish, the coral snakes, etc. Very important is their significance in development of tourism, as the corals, they keep the water, okay, they keep the water filtered, okay, they will be important for underwater tourism or underwater activities. Like for example, Australia has earned a significant part of their GDP from the tourism in Great Barrier Reef. And last is homeostatic mechanism. What is homeostasis? Homeostasis is nothing but the stability, or we can say self-regulatory mechanism. Means what? The corals have the unique ability to balance their own conditions. They keep the water clean and filtered. You can find that these waters near the areas of the coral are crystal clear. They can be like aquarium at many places. You can see through these waters. Right. So this is known as a homeostatic mechanism. And we can also say that in general, the corals are also the reef region or the fishing zone. They are important for the human settlement. So you have coral islands, so and so. Okay, so there are many such significance, but this you remember as important one. Theek hai. So now what are the types of reef? Yeah, first you understand what is happening or how the reef is created. See, this is the sea level. And this is some rock. Now the corals are attached to these rocks. See, understand that the corals will not be able to survive. Corals will not be able to survive what below from this, what should be the maximum extent? It should be 200 meters. Okay, so corals will be present only within these 200 meters because the maximum extent of the penetration of sunlight in the ocean, we have discussed in our ocean profile also that maximum extent of penetration of the sunlight is 200 meters. So this rock has a coral attached to it. Aur ye coral kya karega? During its life, they will secrete. So this coral is going to secrete some compound which is rich in calcium, which gets cemented around its body and create a hard layer like this, hard skeleton. And the coral is going to get protected by this skeleton. Yeah, so it is up to photic zone, we are saying. Theek hai? So corals are present in photic zone, you say. Aur ye coral kya karega? Within their life, when they are alive, they are going to secrete lot of calcium and other cementing chemicals which get accumulated around their body and create a hard structure. And this coral is protected by this hard structure. And this together is known as what? Polyp. Okay, polyp. Coral with their hard structures is known as a polyp. So is tara se polyp bante jayenge. So you'll have these corals creating polyp and the skeleton, and they will stay in this. When these corals die, they will leave this hard skeletal back as it is, and the new one will be created. New corals will be formed here. New coral will emerge here. They will also do the same. They will create these polyps and skeleton, and after they die, then again the new one will come here. In this way, the structure will go on increasing like this, and this may sometimes come very close to the sea level, very close to the sea level, and this structure now is referred as reef. So yes, hope you are following this. What is a reef? Reef is a remains or skeletal remains of the corals, okay, skeletal remains of the corals, and which can be over thousands of years getting accumulated under water, and they are coming up to the sea level. And if the sea level goes down, if the sea level, so yahan par agar sea level is going down here, the corals or these reef will get exposed to the surface, and in such cases we will be saying that this is a coral island, right? So understand, yes, obviously the sunlight is essential for the formation of the coral, kyunki coral is having what, algae. Now photosynthesis hai, so without sunlight there will not be a photosynthesis. Now one point I should tell you here, that the when you say it is a coral island, okay, coral island, the island is not, or corals have not grown above the sea level, okay, corals have not grown above the sea level, it is the sea level that has fluctuated, the sea level has gone down, and because of which the corals or this reef, they got exposed, okay, they got exposed to the surface, and that is resulting in the formation of the coral islands, right? So now when this reef is growing, this reef is growing in different shapes. So based on the shape of this reef, we are having three types. Number one is the fringing reef, then second is barrier reef, and third is atolls. Okay, so there are three types of reefs: fringing, barrier and atoll, right? So understand step by step, we will cover all what you are asking here. They say some are asking like lagoon and all this will come ahead, okay? So just understand first the process of formation of the reef, and then see, now in structure you will find what is a fringing reef. See, this is an island here, this is an island, right? And here is the reef, right? So here you can see the picture. So this is an island, and immediately attached to the island there is a formation of the reef. So this is the island, and the formation of the reef here. So when the reef is formed immediately attached to the mainland mass, okay, mainland mass, it is not leaving any gap, it is attached to the periphery of the mainland mass, this will be referred as a fringing reef. Fringe means periphery, so formed attached to the mainland, right? So this is fringing. So this part what you are observing here, or this is the raised structure in between, so this will be an island, and here is reef, okay, and this is what, sea level, right? So now what is barrier? Now barrier reef means this is an island here, and this is a sea level, and here is the formation of reef. This is a reef, and this reef is formed away from the mainland, and in this way this gap is filled with water. there is a water body lying between the reef and the main island, and this water body is now referred as lagoon. Okay, this is a lagoon, right? So here the land is holding the reef, and there is a formation of the water body between the island and the reef, and this water body is known as a lagoon. So you can see this here, this is an island like this, and here is the formation of the reef in this way. So it creates a water body in between. So this is the formation of lagoon. See, in this image also you have, this is an island or ye hai reef, aur iske beech mein this one is the water body left here. Okay, so this is the formation of lagoon. Jaise you can take example of what Australia in this way, and you have the reef of Australia. This is referred as Great Barrier Reef. This is a Great Barrier Reef. It is not attached to the mainland here, so this is in between, you have formation of lagoon. Is it clear now? What is the difference between the fringing and barrier? Fringing will be formed attached to the mainland, and barrier will be formed away from the mainland. So barrier will have formation of the water body between itself and the landform. Yes. So, and what is atoll? So atoll is, so if this is a sea level, here is the sea level, and the landform is here. So what is the characteristic feature of atoll? There is no island or there is no landform lying above the sea level. The reef is growing around this. Okay, so there is a formation of reef here, and here also there is a formation of a reef. And in between you will have the formation of, this is lagoon, this is lagoon, this is reef, here also this is reef, and this is landform. So submerged, substratum, okay, submerged substratum or submerged landform, submerged landform, this will be having in between the formation of the large water body, and that will be known as a lagoon. So you can see the picture here, where see this is what reef, and in between there is a, this is a lagoon, formation of lagoon, and this is a reef. You can see the cross section here. In cross section this is the landform and this is a sea level. So what is this part? Is a reef, and in between this is the formation of lagoon here. Now it is not essential that all these corals, they only formed at the continental shelf. It depends on, see, remember that the corals are highly condition specific. Okay, they are not found at all the places. If there are suitable conditions for the growth of corals, then only they will be formed. Okay, so we will see that why these corals are growing in this way only. So there are some conditions required for the growth of the corals. So atolls are very common features of Lakshadweep islands. Okay, Lakshadweep island, and it is also a major tourism attraction, tourist attraction in Lakshadweep islands, right? So you can again have a better understanding here. See, this is fringing reef. So fringing reef is developed attached to the mainland. Okay, so it is attached. In case of barrier, kya hoga? This reef is away from the mainland. So yahan par ek water body banega. Right, and atoll, you can see here, this is, you have the reef on both the side, and in between you will have a water body. Yeah, so here, see, in case of what Ankit is asking here is lagoon and all. See here, what plays an important role, not only the coral, but there is subsidence of what, this land. When the land is subsiding and land goes below the sea level, you'll find that the corals, they are growing on the sides. Okay, so understand that this growth of the coral is also related to two factors. One is landform, subsidence of the landform, and second, it is related to the change in sea level. Okay, changes in the sea level, right? Okay, so this is, I think here you are clear with what is the difference between the fringing, barrier and atolls. And most of the theories, they say that this, the first formation of the reef is fringing, and then it gets converted to barrier, and then it gets converted into atoll. Okay, so here it is like there is a sequential. Most of the oceanographers and ecologists, they are of the opinion that the formation of the reef is a sequential phenomenon. It starts with the fringing reef and get converted into atolls. Right? So the same diagram, you can understand it in a better manner here. See, it starts with like this. This is the first one. Let us say island is created by volcanism. Then after this volcano stops erupting, you'll have the formation of the reef. Okay, when this land gets subsides here, so there is gap created, and the same fringing reef get converted into barrier, and the land, when it has moved below the sea level, only reef is seen on the surface. Okay, only reef is seen on the surface, and this is going to be atoll, right? So it is 1, 2, 3, and 4, one after the other. So why is land moving down? So there may be multiple factors for this, like plate tectonics, denudation, so and so, right? Yes, hope these things are clear now. Right, now distribution of the corals. Now this is a very important point for us, distribution of the corals. So corals are not uniformly distributed, and they are found only in specific region. So they are restricted to certain regions of the world. So if you can understand the distribution of the corals across the globe, you will be, if I can show it on the world map for you. So this is, right, right? See, where is coral? I'll mark here. So first is this one, the Great Barrier Reef. Okay, so this is the Great Barrier Reef of Australia. This is the largest accumulation of the coral at one place, right? So Great Barrier Reef. Then you will find some scattered corals in Pacific Ocean. Here, this is known as Micronesian and Polynesian islands of Pacific, right? Then you will find the corals in near some of the islands of Southeast Asia. This will be the Indonesian region, Indonesia, Malaysia, these areas. Then you will find here, that is Andaman and Nicobar Islands. You will find in Lakshadweep. You will find in Maldives. Okay. So this is Andaman and Nicobar. Then you have Lakshadweep. Then it is Maldives. Right. Now specifically if you see, like, there are some corals that are found at the coast of Gujarat. They are also found in Gulf of Mannar in South India. Okay. But if you are talking about where is the largest accumulation of the coral, you will find Lakshadweep Island, and then you will be finding it is there in Andaman and Nicobar Islands. And you will find some of the corals near Madagascar. You will find again important coral formation in case of Caribbean. Okay, Caribbean island. And you will find here in case of what, that is Argentina or Falkland Islands of Argentina. Right. So this is the distribution of the corals. That is Caribbean Islands. Right. So southeastern coast of Argentina, here also this is important accumulation, region of accumulation of the corals, right? So this is the distribution of the coral on the world map. So what you can understand, what you can conclude from this distribution or from this map is that the corals are restricted only in the tropical region. We are not getting the formation of the corals or coral reefs in the temperate region and polar region. We don't have the such clustering of the corals in the temperate and polar region. Yes. And next is the corals are not well developed on equator. Okay. Equatorial region, if you see, you don't have much of the formation of the corals on exactly on the equatorial region. That is between you can say 5 degree north to 5 degree south. Okay, so this is again important point. On equator, there is no much formation of the coral, not that growth that is found in the tropical region. And corals in case of continent, like you say Australia, it is found on the eastern side, but it is absent on the western. In Africa also, it is absent on western. Again, it is absent on western in case of South America also. Right. So this is our conclusion. What is that? The corals are found only in tropical region, that is 30 degree to north to 30 degree south, and they are found on eastern margins of the continent. They are absent on the western margins, and they are less developed on the equator. So it means that the corals require certain specific conditions for the formation of. So what is this? So you can say that the most favorable temperature is 23 to 25, but range, if you say, they can be from 20 to 25 or 26 degrees. This can be the range of the formation of the corals. Okay. And they require saline waters. Fresh water is not suitable for the coral. Salinity should be around the global averages. Okay. It should not be very high, not more than 40 or not more than even 36-37 also, because when you see the Andaman Nicobars and Lakshadweep or Arabian Sea, the salinity is around 35. So they are surviving in this 35 and 36 also. So this is the range of salinity. There should be some substratum within 200 meters. The corals cannot grow from what ocean floor, and corals require sediment free and clean water. Sedimentation is harmful for the corals, right? Sedimentation is harmful for the corals. Right, so these are some of the important conditions required for the coral growth. Most important, you remember the temperature and salinity. Disturbance in water is harmful for the coral. So we'll say stability of water, stability of salinity, stability of temperature. This is going to be the primary condition for the formation of the corals. Clear? So now, what is a coral bleaching and how this coral bleaching occurs? So here you can see in this diagram a healthy coral. So if you see this view, so this is a coral structure, and you take a microscopic view of this, so you'll find this is a coral, and attached to this coral is algae. So this is a algae. Right? And if these corals are getting stressed, what will happen here? You'll find that these algae are going to die. You can see here the pigmentation of the algae is getting reduced, or we can say they move out. Okay, and over a period you'll find that these corals is going to turn into colorless or a white structure. Okay, it is going to, so this is the result, and this is a bleached coral. Right, now algal bloom is a different phenomenon. Algal bloom is simply a growth of algae in water. So for example, you see here is the sea level, or iske niche agar corals hai, this is a coral. Algae is going to grow here, right? So this is a floating algae, you can say, which is growing on the surface. So ye algae kya karega? The sunlight is trapped here itself, and it will not allow the sunlight to reach the algae of the coral. Okay, so this can be again a reason for the process of bleaching. Right, so why this bleaching occurs? What are the reasons for the coral bleaching? So we can say any conditions that are required for the coral growth is altered, there will be the process of coral bleaching. So we can, coral bleaching is the product of two things or two factors. There can be natural factors that cause the coral bleaching, and there can be human induced factors. Natural factors and human induced factors. Right, kya hai natural factors? Natural factor is global warming, climate change, wherever temperature of the water is increasing, increased frequency of the cyclone, right, increased frequency of the flood. See, floods are also going to be dangerous for the coral, because floods causes sedimentation. Remember one point here, that the floods are going to bring sedimentation and sediments, and sedimentation is harmful for the coral. When this mud or sediments, they get into the area of the corals, this sediment will go and block the pores of the corals and the coral will start dying. Right. So in this way, we can say floods, and we can also talk of change in sea levels. Okay, change in sea level. Why is change in sea level caused? Okay, this is related to deglaciation. Because the temperatures on the earth is increasing, there is melting of the glacier. Okay, melting of the glacier, and this is going to cause rise in the sea levels. Okay, so global warming or any factor that is causing increase in ocean temperature. So as some of you are asking, ozone depletion. Yes, ozone depletion also can do that, because if ozone is depleting, then it is going to cause more energy to be added to the ocean and causes increase in temperatures, right? So you can relate anything that causes increase in temperature of the ocean or disturb the water can relate, can be related to the process of coral bleaching. Right. Now, what are human factors that can cause bleaching? So I can say overfishing in the areas of coral. Yes. Then this can be mining of the reef, Right. Then number three is extraction of certain species of corals. Nowadays, because the corals are becoming increasingly important for the pharma industry, right? So there is over extraction of or use of these corals in many areas, right? Then you can have phenomenons which are very common nowadays: oil spills, unsustainable, okay, unsustainable tourism. Like in case of Australia, most of the Great Barrier Reef of Australia has been depleted because of this unsustainable tourism. Then we can also talk about agriculture at the coast. Coastal agriculture also contributes. Okay, coastal industries, or we can say these coastal industries, they release the pollutants, okay, pollutants directly into the oceans. Agriculture using lot of chemicals and pesticides, this also is going to cause the bleaching of the corals. In this way, these are some of the examples or some of the reasons, human induced reasons, that are going to cause coral bleaching. So coral conservation is one of the major agenda in case of conservation of biodiversity. So how to conserve the coral and how to protect that? So there are strategies adopted by every So there is a power cut here, but we are able to complete it. It's like the last slide only. So I think you have got the process of this coral bleaching, right? Yeah, so power cut or power supply got disconnected, so there is a issue, but we are coming to the last leg of our session. So